Oh, and we have another Vanessa. Hello, Vanessa. All right, station two, we have Spider-Man lunge, and then we're gonna twist towards our front foot. You guys can begin in plank here. Two, one, and go. So try and get that foot up as high as you can near that hand. Lift the hand up that's right beside your foot. That way you're twisting towards your front leg. And you're gonna step back and then you're gonna swap. Good. Targeting our hips with this one, our hip flexors. You may get more of a stretch if you keep that back knee off the ground. And then of course, we're also targeting our thoracic spine with that twist. Keep reaching up and back every time you bring your hand overhead. Okay, you guys can break. Very good. Next, we'll go down to the ground. So tummy's down, forehead's down, and 20 seconds each of, if I was lying down, I have I's first, then Y's second, and then W's third. Go ahead, I's first. If you don't get a lot of range of motion out of these, that's okay. Do your best. Reach your fingers forward. Keep your arms straight as best as you can. All right, switch to Y's next, guys. So slightly further out. Good, keep your feet down on the ground. Just focus on using your arms. Okay, and now you guys can switch to W's. Good, nice, Doriana. So now you're pulling your elbows back. If you find these easy, hovering really close to the ground, then lift your elbows higher, create more space between the floor and your hands, and perform these reps with your arms a little bit higher off the ground. Okay, awesome. You guys can come back up to your feet. We're gonna go through the hands on our toes squat again whenever you're ready. Hold on to your own feet and then pull yourself down into your squat and lift your hips up. Pull yourself down and lift your hips up. Try and get a good firm hold off of your own toes. And try and get your shoulders back and your chest through as you're holding the bottom of your squat. Nice job, everyone can break. All right, we have Spider-Man lunge and twist coming up again for round two. Oh no, Steve. They're gone. Oh, perfect. Go ahead and start, guys, sorry. Technical issue. Oh no, they're all gone. Hopefully by this second round, you're feeling a little bit more loose in your hips, maybe a little bit more loose in your upper body as well. 10 more seconds here. Last 5 seconds. 3, 2, one, and rest, good. Okay, you guys can get ready for your tiny shoulder muscles work coming up. I's, Y's, W's in 10 seconds. Okay, beginning with I's in 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Vanessa D, can you see? So you're lying down, forehead down, and then your arms go straight overhead. Good, try not to make this a Superman, guys. Don't lift your feet either, just your arms. Okay, you guys can switch to Y's. Hands slightly further apart. Try to keep your lower body static and relaxed. Try not to tense in the lower body. You're just letting your shoulder blades and your shoulders, your upper back do the work. Okay, and lastly, switch to W's. Last 20 seconds. Now you're gonna pull your elbows back as if you're doing like a row. 10 more seconds. Yeah, good. Lead with your elbows. Don't worry about where your hands end up. Just get your elbows as far back as possible. 2, 1, and done. Awesome. Okay. Very good. Stand up, shake it out. So for our skill today, we have 4 rounds, 3 different exercises, 12 minutes in total, EMOM style. We're all moving at the same time here. The first station is going to be a tempo overhead squat with a dumbbell or some other weight that you can hold in one hand. And there is a tempo that's written there, but I think it's a little bit too long to get both arms done in 1 minute. So what I'm going to get you guys to do is just consider these slow, controlled single dumbbell overhead squats for 5 per side. Try to spend about 45 seconds in total doing this station. Okay, so kind of have an eye on the timer when you're doing these. Here's my dumbbell. Here we go. All right, so choice is yours how you would like to hold the dumbbell. If you want to keep your palm facing in or your palm forward, or holding onto the actual head of the dumbbell is fine too. You're gonna get the dumbbell locked out overhead, and then other arm comes out in front or to the side, just for some extra balance here and control. And then you're gonna squat down and stand back up. Again, what I was saying is I want you guys to try and go a little slower than you would normally perform your squats. This will ensure that you're keeping your core tight throughout the whole range of motion and not using momentum, and will also truthfully probably kind of remind you of where you are in your squat and ensure that you get low enough. Okay, so you want to get your hips below the crease of your knee. I know it's hard with an overhead position, let alone one dumbbell, one arm overhead only. So like I was saying, just try and go slow, spend about 20 seconds per arm, 45 seconds in total here, okay? Station 2 is going to be pistols. So 8 to 12 pistols, depending on your proficiency in this movement, alternating sides, 4 to 6 per leg. If you have pistols, perfect, practice, do them. If you don't, an option that I like, we actually had pistols 2 days ago, so I was talking about these then, some of you may remember, but an option that I like is called a kickstand pistol. So if you don't have a single leg squat, you can't get yourself all the way down and stood back up on the one leg. Very challenging movement. Bring your foot right behind so that when you squat down on the one side, you can push all of your body weight on that front foot, but your back foot is on the ground and kind of acts like a slight extra support. Literally think like the kickstand on your bike. And yeah, Stefania, bring your foot closer to your heel, like right behind your heel. And then you can kind of push off of it as much as you need, but try to tip your shoelaces down so that you still have most of the weight on your front foot, okay? So that's one option. You guys know when I did it, I like to counterbalance myself by holding my own foot. If you have a lightweight, you can hold that in front of you as well as a counterbalance, not too heavy, because then you're gonna create a harder squat. And then kind of counterintuitive to squatting. A lot of the times, any other kind of squat, we're saying, keep your chest up, keep your chest up. You will have to fold forward in a pistol, okay? You have to do that in order to get your body weight centered on one foot. So lean forward as much as you need to get your weight centered on the front foot, okay? Lastly, if you have something else around you to hold onto, you can do a modified pistol as well by holding onto that, whether it's the wall, a chair, if you have like rings, or I think someone was saying they had a TRX. I think Brendan had a TRX. Or if you have like a chair, I think I saw Andrew using a chair one time, anything like that to just put support on and still allow you to get your hips below the crease of your one squatting knee, do that. Okay. If anyone is, working through an injury or this position with their body is not possible, you can always do, something like step ups or lunges instead. Okay. So a few different options for you guys there. And then the last thing is pretty straightforward. We have frog pumps. So refresher on these. You're gonna put the outsides of your feet on the ground. And then you're essentially performing a glute hip bridge, but instead of your feet flat, you're pushing off of the outsides of your feet. And for that station, we're going for 50 seconds, okay? So before we begin with the clock here, does anybody have any questions? Are we okay with these exercises? Questions about modifications potentially? We're not good. Look good. Okay. All right. Awesome. Okay. So we'll get the clock up on the screen here. And there is your strength piece, all the movements. All right. So we're going to begin with 5 per side, single dumbbell, slow controlled overhead squat. We'll go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and begin. So try and watch the timer, aim for 20 seconds per side, 4-ish seconds per rep, okay? Slow controlled down, slow controlled up. Hard part here is keeping that weight up and back and getting your hips as low as they need to be, which is below the crease of your knee. Good, keep pushing the weight up and backwards to keep it over the middle of your body as best as you can. Nice job being slow and controlled on the way down, you guys. Good. Okay, awesome. Good work. All right, we'll get ready for pistols coming up next. When you're ready, 8 to 12 for the second minute. 8 to 12 reps. So 4 to 6 per leg alternating. Good, remember you're trying to get your bum still lower than your knees. Drive through that front heel. Good, nice. Vanessa D, those look good. Nice, Ariana. And Vanessa S, good. Anya, keep leaning forward, guys. I know it's weird for any type of squat to be completely bent over like that. Good, Andrew. All right, very good. In 10 seconds, we have frog pumps. Get ready, guys. 3, 2, 1, and begin. So you're on your backs. So you have your feet in butterfly position, essentially. And then you're pressing your head and shoulders into the ground, your hips away from the ground. We're going for 5-0 seconds here. As many reps as you can. You can get an extra second to squeeze at the top if you like. More seconds here. Three, two, one. Very good. All right, come up to your feet. It's a quick transition to get back to your dumbbell for those overhead squats. 3, 2, 1, and whenever you guys are ready, we're into round 2. Pushing up and back, kind of resist as you go down. Push up as you stand. Good. 5 reps per arm. Smooth, steady reps. Good, Gabriella. About 20 seconds per side, 45 seconds or so, not 45 minutes. Okay, cool. Once you're done, we'll get ready for pistol work. 2, 1, and begin. Yeah, that's it. Good. If you're doing that kickstand version, keep your toes right behind your front heel. Not so far back like a lunge, but right behind the front heel. Yeah, that works too, Giovanna. Good. Alternate legs, or you can do same side. That's cool too. That's it. Try and close that space between your chest and your thigh will help you to control your body weight over your front foot. Okay, guys. All right, 5 seconds. You have frog pumps. 2, 1, and when you're ready, on your backs. Good. Get your hips up as high as you can here. Squeeze your glutes. With these two, you can play with your foot position slightly. So see if it feels different for you with your feet, with your heels closer to your hips versus a little bit further away. Hit a different part of your glute and different part of your hamstring, changing your foot position there. 5 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1, and break, good. All right, back to our overhead squats, round 3. When you're ready, guys. Get that weight locked out overhead. Good, Doriana. Try and send your hips back and down, keeping the pressure in your heels there so you can push through them to stand up. Try not to let yourself get too forward onto your toes. Nice, guys. Nice, Vanessa. S, good. Okay, awesome. 4 seconds till pistols. 2, 1, and begin. Nice and close with those back toes right up against your front heel. Nice, Vanessa D. Good, good, yep, it's okay. Good work. You guys can think about where your knee is going to. Try and push it out over towards your pinky toe as you're squatting down, as you're driving up. Good, Andrew. All right, guys, very good. On your backs for frog pumps again, when you're ready. Good, 50 seconds worth. Small range of motion exercise. Try and get as much range of motion out of it as you can. Drive your hips up as far as possible. Very good. Squeeze for an extra second at the top. Some people have added a dumbbell or band. That's also awesome. All good. 5 more seconds till we begin round 4. 2, 1, and rest. Good. All right, last time on overhead squats. You guys may begin when you're ready. Good job. Let's go, Brendan. Good. Think about where your knees go on these too. Try and track them over your toes. Good job, guys. Nice, Gabriella. Awesome. All right, those are done. We'll get ready for our last time through pistols when you're ready. Pistols are challenging. They require a lot. They require good balance. They require some coordination. They require single leg strength. They require, too, appropriate mobility in your hips, knees, but especially in your ankles. Work through the option that is best for you. Nice. Keep getting your bums low. Keep pushing your knees out over your toes. Keep leaning your chest forward more than you're used to in any other kind of squat. Alright guys, very good. We have our last minute of our skill or our strength portion coming up. Go ahead. Last 5 seconds of front pumps. Again, you can play with your foot position a little bit if you'd like. Play with your tempo. You can go down slow. You can squeeze that extra second at the top. Try and focus the movement in your midsection, in your glutes. Head and shoulders pressing into the ground. Outer feet into the ground. Hips up and off the ground. Last 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Very good. Very good. Okay. Shake it out. Don't rest your legs too much because you're going to need them a whole lot more for this workout. Super leg day today. Okay, so depending on which types of weights you're using, I'm going to show with a duffel bag. But you guys can, of course, do this with one dumbbell, two dumbbells, a barbell, like I was saying. So 5 rounds for time, 12-minute cap. Short time cap for 5 rounds. On that note, I'm gonna say maybe aim, if you can, to finish your first round around the 2-minute mark, and then that way you kind of give yourself a bit of a buffer for fatigue to kind of set in through later rounds. So we have first movement, burpees over your bag. So we can do these laterally. You're gonna lie down. Instead of the jump up from your burpee, you're gonna jump over your bag. Then you're gonna do your second burpee on the other side and then jump back. So 5 per side, 10 in total. Movement 2, you have a squat clean thruster. So you're gonna take your bar bag weights, dumbbells from the ground every time. You're gonna bring them to the shoulders, pass through a front squat and drive directly overhead. So from the ground, I'm gonna bring it to a front squat and then go right overhead. Back to the ground, front squat and right overhead, okay? If I show you maybe a little bit more clearly with dumbbells. So you're gonna go from the ground, catch on the shoulders, front squat, and then overhead. It's essentially thrusters, but you've gotta touch the weights to the ground again every single rep. Okay, so 15 of those. Your last thing is gonna be overhead lunges. So if you have your duffel bag, you can lock that out overhead and do alternating lunges like so. If you have a bar, I would do overhead lunges with your barbell. If you're using dumbbells, I'll probably suggest using one dumbbell for this, not both. It's very challenging with both. So go with one dumbbell, and then you can switch up the reps on your arm however you'd like. I'd still alternate your feet, but if you want to go like 10-10 every single round, changing hands halfway, something like that, that's probably what I would suggest if you're using dumbbells, okay? Does anyone have any questions with the workout for tonight? All good. Okay, so I'm sure your legs are warm, but take a couple moments now. Go over the squat clean thruster and try some lunges before we start the clock, okay? And then just make sure, of course, you have room on either side of your weights, the way they're oriented, to do your burpees. 2 minutes now, just practice a few reps of each. Good. Vanessa D with one dumbbell, Vanessa S with a barbell, yay. All right. Looks like everyone's had a chance to practice and set up here. Okay. So we'll get a clock up on the screen. I think we'll get your workout up on the screen for you as well. And then we'll begin in about 30 seconds. Okay, you guys? Again, make sure you have room to do your burpees on either side of your weight.
Can you repeat the reps again? How many reps?
Repeat the reps. Yep. So 10 burpees over your weight. 15 squat clean thrusters, and then 20 lunges, 10 per side. Five rounds. Everyone's using something different here. That's awesome. Okay. If we're all good, we'll begin in 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go, guys. Down to the ground for your first burpee. Good. Jump right over your object, whatever it may be. Let's get down. Breathe every rep. Give you one more night to get this. We've had a million, million nights just like this. So let's get down to business. Mama, please don't worry about me. Give Vanessa. I'm about to let my heart speak. My friends keep telling me to leave this. Once you're done those burpees, guys, 15 reps of squat clean thrusters to the ground, then to the shoulders, then overhead. Back to the ground, to the shoulders, and then overhead. Again, we'll make it a thruster. Is that you're doing a full front squat as well. Don't forget that. So Brendan, when you bring the weights to your shoulders, do a front squat and then go overhead. So it's kind of like up, down, and then up, and then back down, up, down, and back up, and then back down. Keep your core tight, guys, as you support the weight onto your shoulders for the squat, and then as you drive through the thruster. Big breath every rep. I like to exhale when the weight is over my head. Inhale there before you go back down for your next one. Good, Doriana. Then Andrew, make sure you're getting full depth squats there, guys. Hips below the crease of your knee. Every time you go up for that thruster, full squat, get low. Nice, Tanya. Yep, that works. Good. Good, Giovanna. couple people on the lunges. Just like with those overhead squats, press up and back on the weight. Core tight, drive through your front heel. Touch your back knee to the ground. 20 reps, overhead lunges. Good job, guys. Keep it up, keep it up. We're just over 3 minutes here. Get as much this five rounds done in 12 minutes as we can. Do your best, it's all good. A lot of legs today, a lot of legs. Good, keep going, Brendan. It's Gabriella. Good, Vanessa D. Nice, Doriana. Good, Andrew, keep that rhythm. Keep that rhythm on your burpees there, nice. Good, Joanna. Deep breaths, guys. A lot of reps for 12 minutes. Try to stay moving as best you can. Hang in there. Go, Vanessa S. Good. Try and get at least five in a row, Vanessa S. Good. That's it, Brendan. Got it, guys. You're looking good. Keep at it. Gabriella. Okay, guys, we're halfway to our time cap. As much of this five rounds done as you can. Good, Andrew. Keep pushing up and back. Touch your back knee. Good job. Got it, Doriana. Keep going. That's it. Go, Gabriella. Good, Vanessa D. Yep, yep, yep. Good, get them all. Good Good work, guys. One rep at a time. Chip away. Go, Vanessa S. Come on. Hey, Shavana. Go, Stefania, that a girl. Guys, you're doing great. Crushing your legs, love it. Keep it up. Four more minutes to work, four more minutes. Give it your all for 4 minutes and then we'll be done. Relax for the night. Focus on the task at hand, whatever set you're on, whatever couple reps you're on. Good job, guys. Way to stay moving. Good job. Go, Andrew. Sit. Good, Gabriella. Good job. Keep it up, Brandon. Good, you've got it now. Get a little lower in your squat, Brandon. That's it. Home stretch, guys. 2.5 minutes. Such a small amount of time. I know it feels like a lot right now. Feels like eternity right now, I'm sure. You can do it. Go, Vanessa S. Go, Giovanna. Go, Vanessa D. Try and get 10. Try and get to 10 on the lunges. Nice, guys. Less than 2 minutes. Go, Doriana. Not a girl. Pick it up, Vanessa S. Pick it up. Mind over matter. 90 seconds, you guys. 90 seconds, and you're done. Good. Just keep counting your reps. Just keep chipping away. You have 1 minute. Six seconds. Go, Vanessa. Pick it up. Pick it up. 50 seconds. Go, Doriana. Vanessa D, you got it. Okay. 40 seconds. I'm going to challenge you guys to all stay moving for 40 seconds. You can start to even think about picking up the pace a little bit. Final push to the end. 30 seconds to go. 30 seconds to go. Dig right now. 20 seconds left. Push, push, push. 15. Come on, guys. Last 10 seconds. Everybody moving. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and you're done. You are done. Very good. Very good. Awesome. All right, before I send you guys off, come into a saddle stretch with me. Hopefully this feels good on your quads right now. Give them a good stretch. If this is for any reason super uncomfortable for you, you have a couple options. You can either go into half saddle, so only one leg is bent, or you can even do like a standing quad stretch if it's too much on your ankles and that's kind of taking over and not letting you concentrate on the stretch in your quads. We'll take deep breaths here. Breathe in your nose and breathe out your mouth. Okay, and then we'll do one more. So you're gonna bring one foot up in front of you like a lunge. And then this one, we're gonna target our hamstrings. So you're gonna straighten that front leg from lunge position, straighten the front leg, and then lean over that that front leg. Bring your chest down to your thigh, and this should give you a good deep stretch in the back of the thigh and your hamstring. Okay, good. Come up slowly and then we'll switch. So starting from lunge position, then you're gonna sit your hips back, straighten your front leg and bring your chest over your front thigh. Very good. Okay guys, awesome. Thank you as always for joining me. Nice to see you guys on a Friday. Have a good weekend and I'll see you soon.
Thanks, Marianne.
Welcome. Bye.
Thank you.
Welcome. Bye, Swanya.